Hello boaters, welcome to Narrowboat Journeys. We're near Kirtlington on the South Oxford Canal and I'm just approaching Pigeons Lock. We're going to go through there and then cruise for a couple of miles through lovely remote rural countryside, and then I'll go through Northbrook Lock and moor up somewhere after that. These boats on the left are winter moorings. Now, if you want to go to Kirtlington, you cross that bridge, and on the right side of that bridge, you go up the lane. It's about a mile to the village of Kirtlington. There's two pubs and a shop, with a post office as well. On the left side of the bridge, if you follow the footpath for about a mile, mile and a half, you get to the village of Tackley. Tackley also has a village shop and post office, and another pub. My procedure for doing narrow locks on my own, and this doesn't work for wide locks, but I drive in slowly, put the bow of the boat gently up against the sill, or the top gate, and then I leave the engine in tick over in forward gear, just very gently, and that holds the boat in position whilst I fill the lock. You need to fill the lock very slowly and carefully. When the lock is about halfway full, I take the boat out of gear, and there's no turbulence after that, so it makes it really quite easy. Thank you. On the right is Jane's Enchanted Tea Garden. It's extremely popular, but unfortunately it's going to be closed in 2018 because they're taking a year off. But in 2019, it'll be busy. This is the rear view camera pointing at me as I'm driving along. On the left is the River Cherwell. It's never really far away from the canal. Incidentally, the woodland on the right you can walk through because it joins onto Kirtlington Quarry, which we'll be going past in a moment. On the right here is Kirtlington Quarry. It was an old cement works, but you can moor here, a great place for barbecues and walks. You can't see the quarry itself from the canal, but you need to go up some steps and that'll take you into the quarry. It's quite a popular place these days, a lot of dog walkers, so if you've got cats it's not a good idea. Just by this water pipe that's crossing the canal is a winding hole. Now look closely on the right of this picture and you may see some deer running around. There's quite a lot of them around here. You don't see them that much in the summer because of the undergrowth is so thick, but in the winter they're quite clearly visible. Here's a shot I grabbed with my other camera. Along here is a really good place to moor up if you want peace and quiet and relative seclusion. Would you believe that just 4 days ago the canal looked like this? They called it the Beast from the East. It was a very, very cold spell. On the Oxford, keep your eyes open for damage to bridges. It's always a good indication that the bridge is a bit low, and to avoid that side. This bridge is on a bit of a blind bend. In the summer, you're very likely to see another boat coming the other way, so be careful under here. There's also a lot of scrapes on the brickwork as well, so it's another low one. Always keep as close to the towpath as you can. And this is it for today. I'm going to moor up here. I'm just below Dashwood's Lock. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.